Allies, turn to pick.
Super good pick. Like, how do the wings respond? Oh, they need another core mid that is good against Potter. And like line up as a whole. Oh no, they have DP, what am I talking about?
Yeah.
10 seconds remaining.
On carry, yeah.
10 seconds remaining.
Probably.
Yeah, they usually run carry void on Shadow.
5 seconds.
Nyx assassin
off lane is good.
Good against Timber, obviously.
Good against Wyvern too.
I feel like that lane's incredibly hard for him.
Oh yeah, like clings against any off lane is like terrible.
All right. Final thoughts on the draft?
My heart is with wings.
Your heart is with wings.
My heart is with wings.
I'm gonna go against, I'm gonna say DC.
And Rascal has no heart.
So let's go ahead and throw it down to the casters right now. We got Toby, Juan, and Merlini.
Thanks, we got a lot of heart down here. It's a heart that loves Dota 2 and has drawn up series 1-1 apiece, Merlini.
Who's your heart rooting for?
My heart roots for great Dota 2. It always
That's
has.
That's a cop-out.
It always
Get out of here, Toby.
I don't care about a cop-out. As long as I have terrific Dota, I don't care. And Enigma.
Maybe one of these games, Toby.
Prepare
one of them.
For battle.
Just one. Just like one. That'll be fine. All right, let's get into it, man. DC, they're bringing in the Clinks. He's a man, the draft panel where they were asking for someone that's able to fight, but someone also that can push towers down. Clinks, he sort of ticks those boxes.
Yeah, and he's much more resilient than the mobile carries, like the AM, those split pushers that you think of that Koko's really good against. I really like the draft.
How long do you keep resolution farming on the Clinks? Do you want him to early rotate? Do we look for the early Orchid build into, like, hero kill rotations?
It all depends on how much they can keep the Nyx Assassin down. Nyx Assassin, they did not go the Iron Talon laning strat this game on Wings.
Yay! They still won with it.
This is the mind game.
I'm just going to throw that one out there. That even though we're sitting there going, we don't understand why this isn't working. Actually, no, we understand why it isn't working, but they still take the game. Yeah, I'm interested to see the timing of resolution.
I also like the Clinks a lot because it gives them Roshan potential. And I think they had a lot of issues with that in the prior game.
Are you still concerned about what the Oracle can bring? We've seen Oracle working beautifully with Death Prophet in the past. Now you've also got potential saving from, I say, from Kunkka, from Void Chronos.
Begins.
That's an interesting timing for a smoke too.
It's just really great for Marauder because it's really difficult to stop her Ags timing, and this way you don't really have to worry about it so much. A double Starstorm, if you get the Fate's Edict out on time, it's not going to do any damage.
This movement from Wings, they smoked up underneath the tower as the Foghorn was going. They're going to make a break for the side shop. Now, a lot of the time, oh, actually, Misery, he's walking over towards this. He's going to reveal the smoke. So they start with the fortunes, and Ice is there. He's waiting for the fortunes to connect. Now they go into the forest. Misery up into the air. Fire strike to Babel. Goes up into the tree line. There's a small path to get out, and Fate's trying to block it. He's actually got himself a stun of Babel. Resolution turns on the damage. Misery will escape. Saskar does actually have a defensive cold and blade. Another current will fly in. Resolution, fortunes, then will connect. Misery lining up for another power strike. Double stun on that one. Fate dropping down very, very low. Misery doesn't have the damage, and he also doesn't have the life to stay on the front lines. They look for another torrent. Nope, Ice just started the animation, but he didn't follow through. So Wings trying to get aggressive and contest this safe lane until they TP their support quickly down to bottom lane.
This is something that we see out of the team fight. Just don't give them an easy lane up top, and Sox and Resolution are having a very difficult time dealing with
that
double
helps.
Melee.
Fu just got time locked on the bottom lane. Combine that with the four, and then Fu's gonna go down. First blood, it goes to Wings.
And on the top lane,
Misery's Fate, so low, Resolution, lower, Cold Embrace is still available, now Misery will arrive, Ice, Fire Strike, she's going for the last swing, trying to find Resolution, but these Searing Arrows doing the early damage that DC required, that arrow flying down, there she is, Resolution will find himself a kill.
And all three of these heroes are very, very low, they're going to have to put in a lot of resources, unless they want to suicide, Misery will steal blood to the Centaur.
That he will, he looks to move between the place and TP scroll, he'll come straight back out to the lane. Look for another rotation to fight.
Wings like doing this. They like. It looks bad if they both die, but they have to expend so many resources, so much HP.
Moves gonna be careful. They're gonna go down here. He walks over. Such a simple combo. Fortune's end into Tarn. We throw it on the top lane. Now bottom lane, he has reacted by this time around, but still no Timber Chain available. So move. Poor man Shield will not save you from that.
He thought he was in a one on one situation, and then he skills up for this one on one build with the level 1 World of Death, the World level 1 reactive armor. In a very defensive situation,
Dyer's
you want to max your Timber Chain.
Under attack.
But with that, might be time to think about that Iron Talon.
Now, this has been a heavy rotation early game. Only 2 minutes into it, we've seen multiple lane switches. The one lane which hasn't really had anything happen in it is that mid lane. It's the Weeha versus Blink lane. The Marana on Death Prophet.
Ezreal smoked up behind, looking for a stun into an arrow. It's only a level 1 stun though, but Blink's so far out with no spirit sight.
And you just still got the Starfall above the two. The Weeha connects on this, down into that Starfall. The target! The secondary star! It connected on Blink! So he does pull that.
He does have the spawn on, but he needs someone to pull up a TP scroll if he wants to get back to the mid lane. He also had to waste a fairy fire for that.
And Misery is not giving up on this mid. It's a little bit different though when he runs an Ogre. Ogre is a lot tankier than the SK, so I'll give some extra respect as Ice Ice comes into mid. Nice turret, Weeha! He's got leap available, pounces himself away. Will bottle and salve up quickly as Misery's rotated to top looking for Faith Bian.
And in the meanwhile, Timbersaw finally gets the space in the bottom lane, going for two reactives. Screw the Timber Chain, he says, I can just tank up.
I'm wondering if this is one of the other reasons why you're seeing rotations heavily into mid. They're trying to pull the attention of Wings off that bottom lane to give Move the space he needs.
And Move still has a lot of reason. I don't know if they're going to be able to press him down. No clarities on the Oracle, and he's only level 2.
They got help though. Ice looks to come in from the rear.
I still don't think they have enough damage.
Do you like this build coming out from the Conqueror going the early point up in Tidebringer as opposed to X Mark to spot?
We see this a fair amount when the Kunkers want to go Armlet first and farm up. Check. It's just a good way to keep up your farm so that you're not heavily reliant on the X-Torm combo to get kills and decelerate your farm. But I think they have enough setup. I really dislike it if you don't have any setup, but with Nyx done, Chronosphere, Oracle Fortune's End,
Radiant's
could be
bottom tower is
pretty
under
easy
attack
for him to land with the Torrent.
Oh, Misery's coming back down to the mid. There's still no Observer Wars this season, but Ice Ice sitting on the high ground. He'll definitely see Misery. Now he puts down his own Ops. It's not something he needs to see Misery anymore. He'll hit him with a turret. He'll actually get a double stun thanks to Yarrow also connecting on Blink. And the combined up Starfall, Misery will back out. Trigger is Sal. So just a trade-off of damage. No kills coming from that.
You have to be careful. Ball. He still has the Arcane Rune on him. Getting a lot of value out of that.
And in reality, he already had the arrow leap and everything else back up, not to mention the low cost.
Who's been stacking up this large camp? Shadow's gonna pull it, but we can see a small contest for it in the bottom lane. It's a 3-stack now.
Well, it'll be easy for Mood to deal with that if he was level 6, but doesn't have the Chakram available yet. Another heavy rotation to top 3 from either side. They start with Illusion, Karn as well. Thunder, he's got that call with Grayson, Oracle. That's where the magical damage goes through the bar track forward. Wants Nyx Assassin, doesn't have the damage output, but maybe with the help of the Wyvern, he will have a Misery to the tree line. The Sal is actually going to get canceled off. It was the Corsic Canal in the Dinners, and now Fate, 28 life. Will it be enough? Is he going to pull up survives, dropping down to 8 at one point! And Wings, the rotation works from the
Radiant's middle tower is under
so
attack.
Close.
Man, that Zal tick really sticks there.
Resolution wants to kill on top lane, however. ISI doesn't have anything to play with. No matter. Resolution, Searing Arrows, and Strafe will take one more, and there she is.
Over.
Resolution, they're gonna answer back.
Another life for the
and
King
stage is welcome from ISI.
One thing about ZC Strap 2 is they picked the Winter Wyvern perhaps maybe a little too late. Expect a lot of physical damage out coming from Wings, but their mid-core especially doesn't really do that much.
Moving for Lee, you don't have his skills really meant to work. You can easily leap away from Crypt Swarm and as well as the Spirit Siphon. No point up in silence yet for the Death Prophet. And I said focusing more on laning as Innocence actually roams around the back line. Now, it is nighttime, so DC had no idea that he moved that way. And Weeha right Shadow next to him, starting with the Sun Fortune, then just for the turn. If it wasn't that, it was going to connect with the Purifying Flames from Innocence. And that's what found the kill.
And that Observer Ward just scouting him out the whole time.
Dyer's
there, but he can't really do anything. He has level 2 Splinter Blast, but that's going to do little in the way to stop their push. Drops an Observer Ward behind. Doesn't look like it was scouted out by Wings' own Observer Ward.
And then in TP support, but from the moon, you don't have any real big ultimates up yet. You don't even have the Chakram, so Moo will walk in. Now, Ice Eyes can wrap around the back of him. As he's just trying to go for the kill on the Death Prophet. They can't hold her in position. The arrow will fly out from Weed, but easily dodged. You can see it coming from a mile away.
no level 6 yet on Moon. There's no chance of them getting that kill. Not really that much damage on the tower, though, so Wings not really getting that much out of there. First Exorcism Radiant has used Scan, expecting a smoke, perhaps.
I think they're expecting a rotation from Resolution, and they are right. But he walked up the opposite sentry mid lane. Attack. That was after the Dust and the Scan was used. Ed, well...
There is a Dust on the Oracle in case they want to... Oh,
the arrow off target. If that hit, Resolution still can't find the kill. He doesn't have enough damage to kill off the Death Prophet in time.
They don't actually have the Fate's Edict on the Oracle, so he can't disarm the...
Oh, top lane, Misery. Nice Sandstorm dodge. They put down their own sentry. Ward called and Grace will pull him out. The Sandstorm is close again. Baris Dry catch the TP out. Digital Chaos. They're looking for that kill. Misery dropping down low. Fate doesn't have much to work with because Stick charges in 1 second. He's got that up now, and he's actually holding onto them. He won't hop, however. Not while Shadow chases down the Winter Wyvern, but support comes in. It's Resolution. He's running down, looking for the kill over on Fate. Leaving Zuska by himself, hunting his own T1 tower. Shadow commits the Chrono Spear. That
your
won't be available, but Resolution shows himself. Time will go cooldown. 3 seconds, 2 seconds, 1 second. Over the tree line and far, far away from DZ's line. They run down, but Resolution's not giving up. The arrow will force Shadow a little bit closer towards the tree line. But Innocence is in the neighborhood.
Simple yet effective. What a juke.
While on bottom lane, Moo can finally take out that stack. Ice Ice is leeching a little bit off him.
Oh, the card. Okay, Ice Ice. TP's away. I'm surprised he didn't go for X, especially considering the heroes that he's up against. A Mirana, a Timbersaw. I usually see like one or two levels, but not three like he's committed. But it's nice damage. Maybe they just want to be able to burst through the down during Chronosphere combo with that Torrent at, boat later.
What do you think about the build on the face of Void? Is Lincoln Sphere really
viable? Dude, he
viable?
Always goes Lincolns.
Like, even in this game, is it really that viable?
They usually go pretty strange items, but that's the only thing that I've seen that's consistent.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Lincolns first almost every game. Good versus Winter's Curse. The last game is definitely good versus the Doom. This game,
Dire's
yeah, I don't
top
agree with it so much,
under
but
attack.
They like it a lot.
Nice detection from Resolution. He was just hovering around the tree line. And Nyx Assassin walks through a sentry ward while Resolution still had vision. And this is the reason now why Misery is hiding behind his own tier 1 tower. But Nyx has moved into the mid lane instead, looking towards Weeha. Not going to find an opening. The Vendetta is going to wear out in a second.
They saw him with the Observer Ward, though. He thinks he's in the fog, but he actually was not. And perhaps they might spring a trap for Fate. And Quake isn't actually going for the Oracle, because he assumes he has a disarm, but little does know he doesn't have disarm, and he's probably not going to pick it up until level 8. So he's kind of been walking around with a get out of jail free card, even though he shouldn't be.
Resolution.
Regeneration
rune right in front of Blink, and Blink is just like, wait, I didn't pick that up, it's not inside my bottle. What the hell's going on? As the skeleton walks Clinks. But that casual put him early on. Trying to find the extra damage. Clink's very, very good at bringing down T1 towers.
He's been running around a lot, though, and hasn't really been able to find that much. He was really doing really well in terms of the CS, but now he's falling behind in that work as he struggles to...
Well, nice scan is up. They reveal the Nyx Assassin sitting in the tree line.
But they have the ward behind the tower. Wings does.
Mm-hmm.
They don't see Winter Wyvern just yet, but now they'll know there's only two.
Nyx is on the edge of the vision. He's going to walk in range of the tower. Faithru will reveal himself. Bottom lane, Chronosphere, over on move. Very tanky. Resolution bringing in the damage move. Chains up. The torrent is well off the mark. It's Resolution. Skeleton Walk will come off cooldown so he can run himself away. They are out while Faye is going to find Weeha back behind the tower. Dropping down that Ring of Aquila to use one charges. And now the commit. It is the Exorcism going to work. Range, the Radiant Sentry wards up so they see Wee. He has to leap up to the tree line. Thanks for his time to know exactly where he is. He can't get out. This one, the stuff will connect. Classical one from Faye. Finding Wee in the trees.
Wow, look at Wee's form. He is so underformed. Not only has Point Booster and then some at this point, but he's about to lose T1. He's tied 2 times at this point. Each Mirana game coming from them getting worse and worse. Resolution coming around from behind. And the TP comes in.
That damage, Resolution stuns up. A Misery brings the extra health. Mirana's rocking forward towards Blink with the damage and enough Misery. The Country Wolf is still down. So the Exorcism finishes him off.
Wow, he's trying to kill him right before the Exorcism. Just burned all that health back to him. And this Winter Wyvern hasn't really been able to do that much. It's great against mass summons and a lot of units that are pushing, but Splinter Blast doesn't really do that much versus a Death Prophet plus one.
Yeah, it hasn't stumped the Wings pickoffs.
Dire's
the push.
Middle tower.
Yeah, they're not pushing with
attack.
Units, they're just pushing with a couple heroes and their ultimates. And maybe wishing he had gone for Max Arctic Burn at this point. Still, they're unable to get those combos. Once Winter Curse come out, he's set up for an Epicenter Burrow Strike follow-up.
Ooh, a lot of trouble.
Yeah, again, they're going for this combination, but now X-Monster not going to run this back, but now the ship, they're on the way, and Burr gets his fill. Weehaw!
Radiant's bottom tower is
under attack. Who needs time dilation when you have Bash?
Faith is looking at Resolution 2, invis up around the tree line. You'll need to hit him first with the Vendetta, then follow up on the stun. Either that or he waits for the Death Prophet, who's rotating up to find this kill. Vendetta will last long enough, but it's a level 1 Vendetta.
Blink is invis. They haven't reserved rewards getting any TPs on top lane, but he thinks he's safe. He thinks he's alone.
Here they go. Resolution. Pop him up. And Resolution. He goes invis, but not in time. They trigger the dust just in case.
Man, that invisibility, he might have been a little bit scared. It's like, oh, okay, next plus one can kill me, but if you don't see him here, there's no way you can pick that thing coming.
Sakura, Shadow jumping in, double chrono misery. He can prep the Epicenter. The question is, can he get in range? Wyvern's already down, and now they're running closer. Misery will just walk over. Shadow's still got time warp available, so we can repair all the damage that's done to him. And DC, again, getting kicked off with no rebuttal.
Very patient trying to get Shadow, however, they are lacking a lot of mana with the Kuka, not enough for that boat. He's going for more damage build.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
And another tower.
Dire's structures
yeah, without the
committal
of Exorcism, this is a troubling sight when you can't even hold your tier 1s.
It's turning in for a kill, Epicenter.
He doesn't want to walk into the side of it, but now he can just use Warp Possession. Slow down Misery. It will connect the follow up stun with the main gun by Alphys. The curse is out. The whole Oracle in. And Burn comes in with a Chakra for Fall Promise. It will keep him from behind, but he TP's himself away to safety. Moves only for something. Actually, he's just looking to get the hell out of here. Exorcism is triggered for the stun. It's on Burn. And it's going to be Wings. Holding the Kimberthorn position. Now the chain up. The last attack. We'll find the kill, but the pawn is arrived for DC. They're running in with a big searing arrow damage. Faith makes a break for the tree line. Still alive. Triggering does too. So no extra infant from Resolution. Time lock. Not going to be enough from Shadow. As Weehaw, pawn is great. Resolution for the pawn. Oh, he can make another stun. Faith the end. He walked himself out. He walked over. He was the last finishing move. He worked at it. Dice will finish him. The torrent, it may not be done yet. Sucks just up towards the air. X mark is off. You ain't going nowhere. Apart from down to the briny deep. Faith doesn't have enough for the stun. Spike Arrow is up unless he connects over from Misery. He tries to raise Space No Timer from Shadow Timer forward. Now he finds the kill. More TPs across. Arriving from DC. Another dish. Compromise right into Misery. Stun. Chakra forward. Moody to turn the tide. This fire's Misery. The one time will keep him back into it. He can go for another Burrow Strike and move. Time lost for a century. He wants to walk out to the T1 towers. No stuns available from Nyx Assassin. But these ones really playing dividends.
Oh my goodness, what ungodly teamwork coming out from Wings next to that side shot.
It's not over yet. Innocence is coming over the Akrona. It's on Weehaw. This is bringing the damage. Weehaw, he is gonna pop like a top. They look for more. Ice. Where is this arm? The Ice Xbox not gonna hit. They turn around, look for T1
tower. Is under attack.
DC. Do they still try and defend this?
Ice looking for an X for the back.
He hasn't got it. Instead, he was actually starting the animation for the torrent.
Dire
but this
tier
1 tower is gone. DC, no more fight. They push the Queen to the top lane. They need that Desolator done. They need the damage. They need the Blink Dagger on Misery.
There were so many small things in the last fight. Stop triggering on the Clink so that he can't get around.
Ice really done this. The torrent. If it connected on Misery, he would have had it. He's actually chasing him down. X marks the spot is available, and support is on the way. Misery back to T1 tower. Now the X marks
so
right
safe.
On top of the tower, pulling out the torrent. Innocent with the damage. The arrows are flying forward. No one's going to get caught by it. The curse is on faith, and it's too late. From Zoxa, Weehaw wants to do something. Resolution's on the hillside, just watching his teammate die.
This is without Faith's point. He's up there happily farming top while DC have all five mid.
Just keep them
toward this aggression.
There is no downtime for Wings.
You don't need downtime. They just keep getting advantage after advantage with every minute that passes.
They're really finding their stride.
Is the group ever getting to go for a smart? They're under the T1 town, so yeah, they are. They really don't want to stop this aggression.
DC, they really need a Bezo out on Quake Sister and the Rose Run. They need some more items to get back in this game right now. All their cores are falling like flies. Squeeze Network.
of shadows.
Dire's top tower
Misery.
Is under attack.
Luckily for him, he doesn't turn to the side. Unluckily for Zoxa, X marks the spot. And once
Dire's
again, his dust is in. Misery will not be able to get back there in time to help out.
The corner break has done next to nothing in this
Radiant's
game. Though. The
bottom
Oracle
tower
Max
has
Purifying
fallen.
Flames has just burst hero after hero. Wings should claim another tower on this.
Surprisingly enough, they commit exorcism. This early on, they potentially could have been looking, honestly, to look towards a tier 3 tower where there's 17
Radiant's
minutes in.
The way the game has developed has been completely different from what DC had expected, though. Shadow maybe going for a Chrono on a Wii, but they wanted to just forward out the lanes. They have the spam with the Timbersaw, the Starstorm, the Winter Wyvern spam, but the way Wings are taking fights, it's not really at towers, or they're circling around behind you, splitting up so they're not getting caught by the curse, not getting caught by too many multi-man burrow strikes. It's just a very chaotic fight where DC need order. They need time. And they need that.
They don't have time. They're playing against the Master of Time. Face is void. Like, he can control.
His time that is really spot on. I was like, man, that thing's only level 1. It seems like it lasts forever.
Mm-hmm. And it seems like Wings always know the Oracle did tell them how to play up against DZ. If they can keep this momentum up, they could be looking at a 2-1 advantage in a TI Grand Final.
I think the bigger problem is that Kunkka's getting far. You mentioned his early Tidebringer build earlier. Now, his armlet complete along with the phase. He is becoming another core.
And the Blink Dagger on Deathrock makes her almost an initiator.
Wow, she has Blink. That is a very unusual build for Deathrock. But I think it's really good because they need the position. They just need to be able to run on the back line, force Bronze to use Leap, force Timbersaw to use Chain.
He's not denying the Sentry Ward, so it doesn't reveal his position. He knows it's there, but now DC smoke up. And they're coming for an opening. They're pinging and saying, I can see the Kunkka. We know they're headed down. There's no bottom runes. Not going to go that far.
Oh, the scan.
The sentries are down, but now Faith, he moves over. The sentries, he's out of range. He just goes straight past him. Gets a double stun on Nu and Weeha. Blinks. Oh, no, he's stuck. He has to go invis for now.
They don't know where he is.
No, they don't. He's not even meant to be there, so they can't predict he's going to be there. Shadow will come over and free his teammate.
At least they have two Observer Wards in the area. They got something out of the smoke, and one is just out of range of the Radiant Sentry.
Radiant's
so perhaps
middle
with
tower
this,
Cleave
can
attack.
Sneak in and take Roche. I don't think he's strong enough to take by himself, but maybe a Cold Embrace here and there will be enough to secure that Aegis. But more importantly, they need towers. And they'd like to see some maybe back to the
Blink stunned by Carapace. Instantly back that Starfall of Weehar. Shadow, he's there. Chrono's up. Moonlight Shadow will not protect the Mirana.
No,
now what a way because they found the Death Prophet. The Death Prophet. What? She blinked away. No one attacked
what?
Her. She just kept her out. She had the Yule Scepter as well. With the extras of up, DC was hoping to kill her off before it could do a lot of damage. Now she'll bring it back over, bring a little longer left on it. Timbersaw up the face, gets the stun. Now the end of the drop, and the end of the drop, and the right forward. Blink going down with the ball, Guzan! The save is huge! Resolution, time dilation out this fight. Sucks has the TP out, but DC, they're losing everything, including the kitchen sink.
Wow, I can't believe that Blink Dagger just worked out for him so incredibly well in that position. Sounds odd.
Well, that's everything about Wings, right? It's unusual, it's different, and it works.
Yeah, that is the crazy part that it works.
Dire's bottom tower.
That was a nice epicenter by Sankey, but they don't have enough damage. That's to take down Blink with the Rom and the False Promise. Like, it's just such great synergy, too. Purifying Flame, you don't even need to cast Base Heat it. Purifying Flame, no one does no damage to you.
Good team, tier two town now, bottom lane, going the way of Wings and DC. They're on the ropes, almost 10,000 net worth and experience behind. The graph just keeps rising for Wings.
And I don't even think the Axe is that game-changing for DC at this point. They have Fate's Edict to counter it, but more importantly, Nyx Assassin, you can just carry Fate right in front of him, and it's been a hit on him if he hasn't had a creep. So a split push Piranha can normally get out of control and farm, but not this game. DC looking for a smoke.
Oh, it's like they're trying to contest a Roshan play from Wings, but Wings aren't in there. Instead, it's Misery, who's going to get initiated on by Fate Beyond. Shadow, Ashe gets a first hit. Misery into the Sandstorm, Fire Strike, just nowhere near. Fast enough. He'll end up going down to Fade Time, not being his friend, and now DC Fade is so close, you can smell it! but he doesn't know! Timber will be the tank with the reactive armor, the blinking around to the neighborhood. A quick sentry down from the wyvern will at least let them know if the assassin wants to walk in. The shadow initiating on the wyvern, this is even more distraction. If DC can get this ABC mortal, it leaves tonight's Wings next to a life.
Radiant's
Tuck's gonna keep his own life up for him, but Roshan down at 3.1 now. Slowly ticking. Mirana taking the top tier 1 tower is almost done. And Wings annihilated.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
He spent so much time running around in the early game, he needed something to compensate him for his troubles. The precious Aegis goes his way, but I don't know if he's the only one left at the end of the fight. I'm still not sure about DC's chances coming up in a team fight. They just need to keep on split pushing, get some more towers to equalize his net worth. It's
becoming
close
attack.
To uncontrollable with a 12,000 net worth lead for Wings.
Well, they need some other key items as well. Like the fact you've had no proper initiation from DC, Mirana, Arisar, Connect, and until that blink dagger is over on Misery, he also has no joy. Resolution can jump in through the back lines. Maybe that's going to be his fun key, but he's going a BKB build next, so he doesn't have an Orchid to control up the Oracle, which may have been his better chance. If either that or you force a false promise on Innocence. And now, here they come, bottom lane. Innocence, they see him behind the creep, no shadows on the lane. And there goes your first one. False promise, Innocence has to use on himself. Shadow, he can time walk off the damage. Chrono is still available. And Resolution, he doesn't have no mana to work with, but Clinks, the damage is still enough. Thanks to false promise, wearing off. Misery, get the hell out of top lane. The fresh blink dagger will get him away from Faith, who has a blink and beat the legs of his own.
And now the Queens can start doing what
he does
best.
Oh my Chrono, stop the Simon. We're actually waiting for a Golden Grace. We have staying alive a fair amount of time,
take
but then.
Me.
Okay, Exorcism to Middle is real. They're looking for more. And they're going to find a fuel center up. Timber hits the ground. Starts with a Timber Chain over. Shadow taking heavy damage. And now Resolution wants to help out. They put himself in harm's way. Here comes the Reaper Center from Misery. The Forest strikes through. It's big on the faceless boy. Resolution's back alive. Given some space from Sucker. Caught on a cliffside. His Arctic Burn War off at a very, very bad time.
The Realm's wearing off. They have to back off now. And finally, they get a Winter's Curse, which is especially difficult with the Lincoln Spear on Faceless Void. But no heroes die on Wings yet again. DC, get nothing. A penny for your troubles.
And a penny will not fuel a war. They have to find some kind of better opening. The Agon Interceptor is now done on Weeha. But it's cost them a lot to give him that much space to get it. Clinks will also have his BKB, so two critical items arriving for DC. In fact, you can still say three after Misery picked up that Blink Dagger. So they have ways to surprise heroes. The Dire Observer Ward on Bot River almost scattered out Ice Ice. A little bit too far away as they can face the end. Rotating around, looking for an opening. Middle lane, Blink, Fire Strike. Again, drop at the hour, looking at this with 5 seconds. Innocent, getting ripped apart by Resolution. He took the false promise onto Blink with a life destroy season. Blink is guaranteed dead when he hits the ground from the damage. It will happen. Clinks will take the kill. Corner Brace keeping Misery up. Sounds for the entrance. Resolution finding a triple kill. Digital Chaos have just pulled out the team fight of their life. It may give them some way to quell the bleeding that Wings have been doing to them.
Finally, they kill the Death Prophet, even though the Oracle has been ever so vigilant sitting behind them. They got caught without the Faceless Void. He has a very greedy bill without a TP score.
They think he's better going, and he will. He'll Chrono, Herb Run Resolution. Hard to find the kill, Colin Braid, the battle, so is the Chrono. They're teaming up, actually really, really close together. And now Blink, Fire Strike, Misery tries to bring more space. Resolution needs to wait for Eyes hit the ground after Yul, and he will do so. Armor toggling his way out, but not enough. Mirana was still there. The Aghanims giving the extra damage.
Not really respecting the Golden Brain that time. Without the Oracle, they cannot burst through that. And that's four kills away of DC.
Gold!
How much does it swing? They had 14k advantage in gold for the net worth. It's going to come back down again. This will be a bigger momentum shift for Wings. They'll still have to get themselves back into the lanes.
The Void has to be the one to protect the Death Prophet at this point.
Do you think you can do this, Faith? He's looking at Misery in the tree lines. Misery can actually get body blocked in if he's not careful. He's starting the stun. He's not certain he wants to do it. The Faceless Void is on his way. Wait, 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 wait. Misery, does he blink? Does he borrow? He'll get stunned. He'll get controlled. And he can't borrow out in time.
How many bashes does this guy get?
He only needed one.
but he got two.
And even with those four kills, DC...
Oh, Resolution, this could be a good snipe. That courier went over the Observer Ward. It's got the rest of the Assault Cuirass on it. To Resolution, one attack is all it needs. 3,000 mana, bit to spare. Net worth hitting the deck.
I'm surprised that Innocence hasn't gone for a Ghost Scepter with how farmed Resolution is. He is the biggest threat. They have a Sentry Ward, so they know he's in between the mid T1 and...
Yeah, that's why ISIS is scared to death. He thought he was running down through the Ancients. Resolution will move up. He'll find ISIS, but...
You can't find it. It's way too much fog for us. Quick enough going to jump in. Faces the way. Chronos Speeder coming off cooldown very, very soon. We
Radiant's
see the
middle
first
tower is
Ghost
under
Scepter,
attack.
Possibly many, coming up on the Death Prophet.
One way to stop the damage from the Clinks, especially when he's going Chrysalis, not Diffusal.
But then it opens up where Marana can do a lot of damage with the Stars Wing, so you have to be careful about how and when they use it.
Very true. What kind of damage do you try and repel? Right, it's almost like you can Fortune's End everybody, unless his Oracle gets to a point of having Refresher.
After those four kills, Wings only possessed an 8,000 gold lead.
Nice Clink dagger up. Now for the Marana. They're looking towards middle lane. Wings smoke up, rotate around. The arrow won't connect. Hunker.
Death Prophet is not close by. Wings have to be careful not to take a fight while he's not here.
Oh, they're going to walk straight in. Confirms on cooldown. Dust will trigger the blink. Misery! Evading the Chronosphere. He's fast enough for it. X-Mark and Spotfire drag Resolution back in again. The arrows will fly forward.
With the BKB on him and no Chrono Ops, this is not to fight the Wings unless they pull them
back. You're under a Sentry Resolution, but now he's not. He's back far enough, right behind Innocence. Starts attacking. Oh! And now Timothy pulls through once more. Blink fire. They found Einstein. Resolution putting that Chrysalis to work. They need one, maybe two hits to hold him up. It's the curse. Chakra, one attack, two attack, three attack, four. Resolution, where is it? Okay, now he finally can hit the deck. Yara will take a triple stun. Misery will turn with one of his own. The Tidebringer. Einstein will finally take a fall. Misery is too far out.
They spot out Shadow now. They ping out on it, but...
They'll walk under an obstacle to get to him.
Yep. I wonder if he's going to go for Bloodthorn.
They just want the T1 tower. Resolution can easily take this. There's no fortification.
Yeah, that's more important Dyer's than the face of the wind.
You don't even need the drink wave. That's the beautiful thing about the Clinks. His damage output is just so quick.
Radiant's middle
that these
tower
towers don't stand a chance.
Radiant's middle
and finally, the support
of
DC gets right about
too close. Is under attack.
Time walks up. They're on the chase. Wee-haw. Arrow on cooldown in 4 second time, leaps forward, actually missing... I don't know exactly where he wanted to go with that.
Just maybe hoping he would TP down there and get an easy arrow, perhaps.
If he stayed on the hillside, he would have just been in the tree line. Another Blink Dagger coming in, this time it's for the Winter Wyvern.
And Misery has dewarded all of the Radiant Wards with his shiny gem. And Roshan going to respawn.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Probably pretty unhappy about the last
Radiant
way that Roshan went down.
Are fortified.
They don't have any armor items.
This can make him happy. Sucks to just blink himself backwards down the Zerg Ward. It's the Arcticlone. He goes inside the pit, outside the pit. Now starts to jump out with the car in the back. The curse, however, the Wyvern. He still can't get down. He'll hold a break by himself. He's still breathing space. As Wings, they commit the Cobra as well. They commit everything. A 5 second arrow will connect on Innocence, but well, you kind of knew the Wyvern was going to die.
At least the arrow scouted out that there was no Roshan around. They see the Observer Ward right now. And that is the gem on the mix. So we have to huddle around the pit.
The
Clink
is
spread is way too much. And they probably have to commit Exorcism to it, though. Which
Radiant's
just
middle tower
in the
is under attack.
To jump upon them in the pit.
Do you really want to commit that much, however? Like, that's...
It's way better to find a pickup, though, than going to the Roche Pit. It's
true.
Far too risky.
It just delays you push high ground if you do it. But then there's no Exorcism.
They're not really in a rush to take high ground, not with Kunkka.
Oh, this will be nice. They find Misery. Misery, reaction, blink up. Still got Fire Strike available. Gonna dodge even up the Sentry Wall. The Chronosphere! This is the gem of DC. Resolution wants to hold out. He can tap the top net. Chrono, he lets the tank at the ball. Chrono, Resolution gets bashed up. Even on the first hit, PKB another bash as well. He'll run away. Where's your curse? 6 seconds till it's off cooldown here for Doctor. He has to back out. Move. In the name of the Chakra, making it difficult
under attack
for Wings to come down.
They don't have their gem carrier. Nyx had a TP at home to get some extra healing from the False Promise in order to survive. Roshan gonna respawn in 2 seconds, but that
Radiant's
is
top tower big is under attack.
Momentum. Swing. Wait, wait, he doesn't have the gem anymore. I think he passed it to Wing. Or we picked it up.
Really?
Pretty good.
You're right. It actually got on the Wing.
Yeah, I thought it was on Misery. I think. Yeah, that's the one he used the Chronos on. Nice pickup.
Man, that was fast. Now it's DC. They still have a slight advantage, obviously being Diocite with Roshan being up.
And their ultimates are up. Sand King, Epicenter still up, Winter's Curse not expended their last fight. So they are ready. Chronosphere is still down from 40. I think this might be a time for DC to say, hey, come at us and Roche.
Nice new item as well for the Tympasaur, picking up a Yule set before this fight. So we've got some kind of escape or control against Wings.
And time dilation counter.
Mm-hmm.
Much cheaper than Lotus. That Observer War scattered out by Vivian, but...
Oh, the curse! Just as Death Prophet blinked himself over, the animal connects his assassin. False Promise will keep him alive, but for now, Death Prophet took a lot of damage. Shadow of the Time Dilation trying to force him out. Move the Cold Embrace, giving him more life. Yule set up towards the end. Assassin stays alive. The False Promise didn't work. So it's only Mu to die. We are the leap, the blink. He's still up, but now he actually runs into Blink. He needs more time. He'll get the Starfall off, but Fabiana can be saved by this Oracle. The rest of DC are away.
First game of Oracle is doing so much work when they can't lock him down. That is the Klinx's job. He has a lot of damage, but he cannot jump on the Oracle. You want him to blow False Promise on himself, and if he doesn't, he's going to die in 2 hits, like we saw on that fight top, especially if there's a lucky crit, which is going to happen a little bit more often now that the Daedalus is complete.
They need to bring the gem back. Is he in range? Can he not attack the horde? X marks the spot. Okay, yeah, now we go. Gem is in over, and pop him. Some verbal words will drop. DC does still have another big advantage. I say this is an advantage. They have no other talents that Wings can easily just move over and take.
Yeah, despite the kill lead being 31-14 for Wings, they're only up 6,000 gold and forcing, spending a lot of time just running Welcome around, back. And also most of the DC's kills are on, or Wings' kills rather, are on supports.
A lot of the kills for DC belong to Resolution. He's taken 9 out of 14 of DC, and it reflects in his items. I'm interested to see where he goes from here. Like, is it worthwhile getting that Diffuser Blade to get through the Ghost Scepters?
Yeah, I think eventually the Ghost is, gonna get more. I don't know, they only actually have one on Death Prophet. Why isn't Sabium gold, so? Maybe not, that's a normal build, though.
The dewarding happened, so DC definitely know the Wings are around Roshan. They're gonna group up, smoke up. Remember, without the Exorcism, there's not a lot of quick damage arriving from Wings. So Roshan, and now 2k life. They're a little bit too far away here, DC, to Roshan. Look at Roshan, Wings, they want to keep fighting. Tendrix are down, leap up, looking for the Chrono! The leaps away, however. Timbersaw, at the Yule Stash, gets the Yule Stash. Chrono, the final end for the Chrono! They got a Resolution! There's a big one! They need to find the kill! Also has to call him break, but there's too much damage there to still find that kill. X marker back, we are. He might get out of this one. The end's gonna arise to Misery. Minimal damage, Wing can just tank through it. Misery, silence, nuke. He's got enough life. He's moving north, and will it be enough? While the battle happens in the pit, Misery will die. DC lose 4 and Wings.
Wow, that Chrono's that's one of those super high-risk ones. It looked like two of them were right about to be on the edge, but he knows the range of that perfectly and catches one of the most highest priority targets. Klinx without a BKB. Lock him down with a Torrent of Boat to follow. No BKB, no Klinx, no damage.
That's the problem for DC.
It's a big problem because Whis not farmed enough at this point. He needs to be able to carry his own weight in terms of doing magical damage to their back line, pressuring the Oracle, but right now he's just unable to contribute because he's died so many times. He's died 8 times this game.
Time is money.
Yeah, it's not a happy game for Weeha this time around.
Illusion. And, I don't know, you mentioned the link here maybe not being the greatest this game, but look at Shadow, 11-0 as well.
He does what's needed.
I don't know, look up for every time.
You're the perfect Chrono, and you've still got the beautiful thing that is Oracle. Like, DC commits so much to finding one hero, and then all of a sudden, Oracle, he's giving the extra life over. We saw that from Shadow in the bottom lane fight. Oracle always had it back.
I also like the Lincoln Spear build because it gives you a lot of HP. If you go Vlad's, which is equally good for farming and sustain, you can just easily get bursted down by the double Starfall or Timber Burst or whatever it may be. But if you have that extra layer of 15 strength, then you can time walk off. Your Oracle has more time to throw that False Promise on you. You have more time for those Cocos ship to come out. Coco's Rum.
DC's ready to go.
You start Warcraft then.
You really want to fight into this if you're DC though, with an Aegis, with Chrono up,
not where
gems.
Wings are basically reaching around. This is going to fight come right behind DC. The scan comes out of the ring. They don't find anyone in biz. They know the Blink is in there, and here they go. Blink triggers the exorcism.
They wanted to be able to spam this with the Timbersaw and the Winter Wyvern, but they're nowhere close. To C3's gonna fall before they really get any damage.
Now the jump comes in. Quick chain away. Wings fall with Virus Strike. It connects with the Death Bomb in the corner. We are emerged. Shattering Path is two again. The Tara Combo. They move down to one move with a double thumb from Fate. They ensure the kill. No time like another one with the Timbersaw. And Blink is still waiting for an opportunity. Resolution sitting outside the base. He has nowhere to go. Blink borrowed ball. Blink takes the defense up over the goal line, kicks back into a mystery, drawn out, another double stop from Raphian, just Lord from Shadow, looking for the damage, and a time will burst in a way, pursuing it, a triple kill for Shadow, the card is good, however, Nikas has to be brought down, the arrow flies forward, misses target resolution, needs to pump in more damage, the gem, stolen by the by Shadow, as he'll run back out to the front line, the Starfall, dodged by the first Mantle, took hit by the secondary one of Blink. Where is this control? Where is this damage? It just isn't there. The silence of Murata means he can't arrow. They see Innocence TPing out. It's going to be too late. The TP was more than well completed before the arrow reaches its point.
Yeah, Betty wish he had the Kuzla now. The Ghost Scepter and the Oracle. This popped out of nowhere at the perfect time. A clean sweep of the melee rack for Wings. These Chronospheres from Shadow, he's really quick with those. They haven't ever worn in the base, but it just lined them up for a perfect impale after Nyxeth, and Winter Wyvern had to blow so many of his spells to try and keep his cores alive.
I like how much Shadow doesn't want to go back to base, actually bringing salves out to himself instead of holding onto the gem, which is on the courier. He'll trigger the second one in a second.
I mean, he has an Oracle on his side. He doesn't even see it much, but...
When
you get your farm up.
When you have a 15,000 net worth advantage, you can splurge a little bit.
DC trying to spring a trap, but the Manta Illusions looks like it's going to scout out any shenanigans that DC can throw on this bottom lane. They can't go into the area. They know those wards are there, but Isaac might run into it.
Yeah, he walks straight over. Misery, does he want to? Does he want to? He doesn't know. Oh, no! Misery! Misery's a target. The arrow will long surface. DC comes to get a Misery. Running circles around DC's missed stuns. They're gonna lose more move. Actually, cornered a little bit further up. Shadow's able to find him to pull the life and a stun in from the next assassin. It gives Shadow the time to get the hit. Weeha, as well as Misery. Misery doesn't actually have a TP score. He'll borrow the right forward. Weeha, no arrow available. So they're looking to kill off Innocence. But now the arrow will fly forward, but it's still on target again. Innocence, with so much confidence, stands his ground, and we can't try to predict him. Move back now in Shadow, again on another run, Dyer's under the tier 4 towers of DC. They do not have a green wave with him, but they can start a pincer.
Innocence might get picked up by Resolution.
Oh, can they do it? There's the Ghost Sister. You can't pick off Jack. Yes, he can now. The green wave is up. He turns it off because it holds that proper position. Shadow jumps over, but now he's in range, but we have the Starfall. Not enough damage at the core star. Goku's run well off the mark, and Realm Misery is the stun there. 1 second, 2 seconds, Shadow, double hit. Knives are quick, finds the pick up on Misery, all you want to do is retreat.
Still alive and healthy on the side of Wings, and with no PKB on Sleep, they're going to have to hope for a miracle here.
Exorcism is down, however, a miracle's been eliminated. Move, there goes your shot from forward. Arrow flies in on target, nice hit from Weeha for the finish. He has been to watch this game. Another big stun. Resolution. He'll finally bring down Blink. There is a spike campus available. Resolution. No PKB charge. So he'll come up himself. Chakram. Or you can just timber change into Whirling Gem. Gem can be recovered. As Moog. Hot on the tails of Eyesight. Daddy has the damage. Whirling Gem. One punch there. And as Moog gets the double kill. A full Raxing on mid and bottom lane done by Wings.
I think it's Rapier time for Clinks.
I think he needs it. Move. This will be godlike if he can get it for the Chrono. How much life has he got? Nowhere near enough. Shadow ripping to the heart. There is no white flag on the door from DC. They continue to fight.
Wings thought they got in the game with the Repressor up on the Death Prophet, but he didn't Yule himself in time. That's actually what killed him. The Klinks was just beating on him. It was very close to the Exorcism being returned, but didn't Yule, and then once she dies, everyone else dies around her. Luckily, they have a backup gem, I think, on the chicken.
Yeah, it's on the chicken along with the rest of almost the entire Shivas for the Death Prophet.
Invisibility!
Resolution, I want to see that 6,200 gold.
He needs something.
Yeah.
The Relic is picked up on Resolution. He needs any kind of damage he can get at the moment.
Yeah, you want to be able to, like, one or two shot the Oracle. Because the Oracle, he doesn't actually have the camera on himself. It's usually on his cores, and he doesn't have a Blink Dagger, so he's especially vulnerable to the Klinks.
With Resolution, he'll still have multiple problems, aka he's down to 4 Diffusal Charges, so by the time he can buy up the Rapier, he may not actually have any Diffusal Charges left.
Yeah, I don't think you can sell an item at this point, too, to get the Rapier. You just have to farm out your 2,000.
Yeah, he needs to
hold a buyback.
Everything you get as an Orca build out from the Void, it's actually, well, one of the most expensive items in the game. The Bloodthorn is arriving for the Faceless Void.
Yeah, you can Yule's off the time dilation, but then you're just gonna get silenced up. And then the Marana has no solution really to the Bloodthorn.
And even that, like, you get the active stuff from Nick Sack. They initiate Iathasic on the kill. The Sun is there on Midway. Yule just sent Iathasic and Midway pulls off now to the double one. DC, they just need to bail out. Even Midway pulls back. Pull and break to keep alive a little bit longer. Fire strikes up for him. And the Kroger on the back line. They found Resolution. It's a big kill. Burning to turn the damage around. And this is to be ripped apart. And he will go down. The cards is too late. Take the attention away from Wings and now Misery will also jump in. Marana dies on the left. Misery, forced up down. Shadow, hot on the tail. Remember, this is DC trying to defend with the two lanes of Megas up. Mu has to buy back, but there's no buyback for me or Resolution. So a hard fight now in front of DC. Exorcism will wear off. That's one upside for them. And Wings will back out. Even with the two cores, they're not going to push the envelope too far. They have the refresh draw on Blink, so you have a second Exorcism if you want to push, but without all 5 heroes, it's just not worth it.
There's a gem just sitting on the ground. I wonder if they're going to try and pick it up with the chicken, but very close to DC's side.
And Klinks cannot get caught out like that. Like, if they can recover the gem,
I think it's more so like Shadow always finding the right targets with the Chronosphere. He knows that the Klinks is the only one that can really do damage to them. Marana's
just
going to
see it. That courier has traveled. The hauler, he's looking for Dwayne. Drop the TP, he's gone. Down the courier, on the silence. Yule will dispel. Coming over, he's there for the Wind of Wyvern. But with the blood, will be enough. The Bloodborn Timbersaw, he's not going to pop that force off him out. Mr. Timber Chainer! They pop him, the gems on the ground, and it's no
your death the moment you are born.
DC, they're scrambling away. Zoxa needs some help. Mystery's there, but again with the silence, forced off up.
9,000
hitting Blink on the back line. They fire and strike forward. Blink is slow with a splinter. It's not enough damage. Shadow the Crunch in Revolution. He walked into it. The damage is there from Shadow Revolution. It's gone. And with it, baby dogs to the game.
What a god on this faceless boy. 20 kills, 0 deaths. Resolution trying to all in with the Rapier in the end, but no death back. Walking in a corner with one of the safe DC as they crumble in game number 3.
Yeah, the big story is that bottom lane missing of stun after stun.
Dire's
you can see how DC.
The
smile turns quickly upside down as Wings have a flawless game, and you gotta say it. It's the way you do it, non-Malk style. 20